Hello guys, welcome to ProWeb Tips YouTube channel. My name is Pranay and today's in this video we are going to see how you can install Redis in your server if you are using shared hosting based with cPanel, or you are using any kind of cloud hosting or dedicated VPS. I'm going to show all steps for all the all types of hostings. So if you are wondering what is Redis, Redis is known as remote dictionary server. It's stored the database structure and also used as a object caching. So it will improve your application's speed. If you are using WordPress or any kind of CMS, it will be very helpful to improve your application performance. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you for the WordPress website. So first of all, we are going to see how you can install Redis and the PHP extension, then how you to configure for WordPress. Okay, so first we are going to see for VPS hosting. So first you need to connect with your server via SSH. So I have already connected to my server, and if I run the command Redis CLI, you can see command not found. Or if I execute the command, the service Redis status also not found. That means our server is not installed any Redis application. So we are going to first install the Redis. I have written an article about how to install Redis in PHP extension. I will put the link in the description. You can read the article for detailed steps. Okay, so first of all, you need to update your system and also upgrade. So you can execute the command sudo apt update and upgrade. Okay, hit enter, and afterward you need to install Redis server using this command sudo apt install redis hyphen server. Okay, so just copy and paste sudo apt install redis hyphen server and hit enter. Now you have to type y, then hit enter. Okay, for now we are going to check it is working or not. For that we can check this status, sudo service redis status, the command. Okay, you have to execute the command and you will see it is running. Okay, now we are going to install PHP Redis extension. For that you need to first check what version of PHP you have installed in your server. Okay, so first of all execute the command PHP space hyphen v. It will show the version of PHP. I am currently installed PHP 8.0, so I am going to execute the command. As you can see here, we have mentioned here you have to execute this command sudo apt get install php redis. Okay, but my recommendation is that if you are using suppose 7.4, then you have to mention here sudo apt get install php 7.4 hyphen redis. Okay, and if you are using php 8, then here you have to replace 7.4 to 8.0. okay, so for that we are going to execute sudo apt install php 8.0 hyphen redis. Okay, then hit enter. Now we have also installed the php redis, and how you gonna check, type php space hyphen m. Okay, it will show the all modules of php, and here you can see redis we have installed successfully. Now how you gonna configure the WordPress? Okay, this is our domain that's hosted on this server, which are recently we have installed the redis server. And if you are using AMP, you must install redis or any kind of object caching system. So now we are going to configure with WordPress. So first click on plugin, okay, then click add new. Now search Redis, and here you can see Redis object cache, just install now and click on active. Okay, here you can see drop-in is not installed, and so just we need to enable the object cache. Okay, hit the object cache. Now here you can see client PHP Redis, the version here and everything is fine, and you can also again check the diagnostics. Here everything is working, and now you can also monitor via command line. First you have to execute the command Redis -CLI monitor, and you have to visit your website, and you will see the result here. Whatever request you perform on your website, it will serve from your Redis cache, so it will improve your performance of your website. So that's a good thing. And now how can install Redis on your cPanel, or if you are using any kind of shared hosting? So first of all, you have to log in your cPanel dashboard, then scroll down and find select PHP version. Here you can see select PHP version, and currently I have installed 7.4 PHP, and all you can see here the modules, some are enabled, some are disabled. So you have to check that Redis is checked here. If not, you have to check on Redis, then it will enable your Redis caching. And then what you need to do, open your website dashboard, and you can install either Redis object cache plugin, or just if you are using Lightspeed cache plugin, you can use that. Go to the setting. Here you can see number 6 object, just click on it. And here you can see Redis extension is enabled, and connection test also passed. Here you have to select Redis instead of Memcached. You can also use Memcached, but for that you have to enable Memcached here. Here you will find Memcached. Okay, now both is enabled, Redis and Memcached. So just you have to select Redis, then, and also you have to mention the port. By default will be this one, 11211. You have to change it 6379 for Redis object caching. If you use Memcached, then you have to leave as it is by default this one. After that, just hit save, and it will work. And you can also cross check is object caching is working or not. Just click on plugin, and then installed plugins, and here you can see drop-ins. You have to click on it. You will see object cache.php. That means your object caching is working. So that's it, guys. And full detailed tutorial I have already written an article about how to configure object cache for WordPress. And so I have full detailed article, you can see here. I will put the link in the description, so you can read and implement your WordPress website, so you get better performance. So guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe our channel. Thank you guys.